to the Stateless Codecast. We're in our third video on the RubyGem series, working with the Nerd Dice Gem. In this video, we're going to do some final finishing touches with the changelog, some RuboCop installation, and that word is my nemesis. If you watched my outtakes for my setting up RuboCop video, we'll set up RuboCop and we'll get the changelog ready and do a couple of other minor house cleaning things before we dive into the code in our next video. So the first thing I'm going to do is I've got this .rubocop.yaml file in the home directory of my computer. So what I'm going to do here is in Nerd Dice, I'm going to add a .rubocop.yaml file, and I'm going to paste it in from the other things. I'm going to not require RuboCop Rails. We're going to get rid of those items that are Rails specific. Rid of the Rails cops. And continue down here, layout style, lint stuff. Save that, and then we'll go into our terminal. This is with the home directory version of RuboCop, so we're going to take a look at our git status, git diff. Okay, so going to run now. You can do a RuboCop allows you to do autocorrect offenses, so we're going to try that and see what it does. We've got pretty much this only thing that we don't have committed is our spec description here. We'll just copy it in case we don't like what happens. And we'll run. Make sure I'm in the right directory. I am. RuboCop-A. Freeze. Okay. That all seems harmless enough. See what. So yeah, just fixing the pre-Ruby 1.9 hash there. So I think we're good on that. I'm gonna run it again. So there are 10 offenses and 8 are auto-correctable. So let's take a look at some of these. Okay, most of these are related to missing the frozen string literal. This might add them in. So yeah, we're adding in this frozen string literals. We're going through most of this is just formatting and adding in that frozen string literal. See what happens now. So now we're down to 2 offenses and they're both related to the gem spec. So here doc delimiter naming, use meaningful here doc delimiters. Required Ruby version. Should be equal. Okay. So I think I'm going to bump this up to 2.7. I don't want to. 2.3 is no longer supported, and I'm not going to run a bunch of CI stuff going back to 2.3. So we'll make that change, and then still getting some try here. No offenses. So git status. All that looks fine. And then going to go in. Got some modifications. We're gonna go to our change log and set that up a little bit better. So we'll start with master. I'm gonna add these things in here. 0. And for right now, we're just going to y, mmpg. So before we release a version 1.0 of the gem, we're going to have that this in here so that we can add stuff to the changelog. And then we've got new features, bug fixes, as of now, this doesn't really mean much. But it will kind of keep us honest in terms of the formatting that we'll wind up using for our changelog. So the other thing that I want to do is modify my copyright notice on my README file. Just wanna going to get the relative path here, so issue the cat command. So this is what I want to add into my own README here. And the other one's my own README as well, but the README of this repo. Stateless code. Your dice, and I'm gonna go. I'll get me there. Check the link in Chrome. That does get me to where I want to go. So take a look. Get to the usage when we go there. All right. That's good enough for now. We'll take a look at some of the other stuff. Okay, that's in our gitignore. These all have our string literals. So I think we can commit this. We'll work iteratively on the documentation stuff, but we'll commit and push what we've got so far. Sure, nothing's included that we don't want included. That all looks good. And I'll pause while I write my commit message here. So we've got our commit message here, and we'll sign it. All right, so we've signed it. We'll take a look at our log. That has what we need. We'll push our code to master. And we'll pick up in the next video. Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.